All right, I think that will do it now. All right, everyone, just sign back in. Hey there, sparkly Canadian crafty girl. Sorry about that, we were having some technical difficulties there. Now I'm just trying to log into the chat. Okay, I think I'm in now. Okay. All right, everyone, sorry about that. Let me see if I can. Oh, I'm sorry, I don't mean to shake the camera. I'm just trying to get the chat off here, but I don't think I can. Okay, that's all right. All right, how is everybody? Sorry for the difficulties. Let me pop the chat out so I can see better. All righty. Does it look good now? Everybody can see everything? I think it looks okay. All right. Mona, you are a moderator. Thank you for not volunteering, but I made you one anyway. Sorry. Hey, everyone. Hey, Stacy. Hey, Strawberry Board. I don't know your name. Could you tell me your name? Hey, Lori. Hey, Christy. Good to see you guys. Hey, Nancy. I got my Teavana tea here. I brewed it a little while ago. Look at that. Look at that Yeti cup. You see the smoke coming out of there? I probably put this in the cup like a half an hour ago. These things are the bomb. Hey, Debbie. Hey, Jamie. Hey, Lisa. Jamie. Barbara. Okay, Amber. Thank you. I'll probably forget and ask you again. Hey, Becky. Hey, Spook Wiley. Hey, Michelle. Hey, Tina. Hi, Frashawn. Good to see you. Hey, Elizabeth. Hey, Grace. Hey, Leah. Oh, you guys all ready to work, huh? Colorful Fish, you always comment on my stuff and I have no idea what your name is. Could you tell me what your name is? Hey, Kim. You know, I should really start like writing these things down because I was getting the hang of it when we were on Instagram. So, okay, so Strawberry, your name is Amber, right? And Meredith, okay, Colorful Fish. Okay, Spook, you are Tracy, thank you. This helps me out so much and then I get to learn your names. I really appreciate you guys doing this. Hey, Samantha. Green Mountain Girl, is that Jane? Hey, Tamara. Hey, Stacy. Hey, Minda. Good to see you guys. What the F are you reading? What is your name? Hey, Amanda. Yeah, I think you might need to refresh. Hey, Dollar Diva. What is your name so I can write it down? Hey, is it M's Color? Is that right? Is that how you pronounce it? I'm just writing these things down, guys, so just bear with me for a second so I can get all your names that I don't know. Sparkly Canadian Crafty Girl. You probably told me what your name is, but I may have missed it in the chat. Can you just tell me one more time, or if anybody knows, I want to write it down. And someday I'll remember these things. Okay, Ashley, thank you. Hey, Mandy, you made it. Hey, Rhonda. Hey, Kayla, Susan, thanks everyone for joining. Oh, Nisi, that's you, okay. All right, everyone. So I have some fun things planned for this evening. We're going to do a picture in here. Frank wanted to pick the picture, so we're going to be working in the new Emily Oberg book, the Sagar Oksagner. So I'll show you the picture we're going to do. He chose it, and I wanted to do something like fall-ish. And this was the only picture that I really thought was fall-ish, and of all the books I showed him, he picked this one. So we're going to be doing this one. Oh, you like my nails, Tamara? they're actually, you probably can't see them in this light, but they are mermaid, and in a certain light, they turn purple. They have like a purple shift to them. You really can't see it at all, like in the light, but yeah, sorry about that, but they look really cool. They have a really nice shift to them. Oh, yeah, he is pretty involved, Stacey. He likes being involved and knowing what's going on and what we're all talking about and doing. I have a feeling he's going to be joining us at some point. He asked me what I would be streaming on tonight, so I'm sure he may be here at some point. No, Tamara, it's a gel color. I don't think it actually has a name. It just had a number, so I don't know. I don't know what it was. I wish you guys could see the purple in it. Let me see if I just turn it a little bit. I don't want to... You can almost see it, but it kind of has to be like a little dark in order for the shift to... Oh, you might be able to see it there. Can you see the purple shift in there a little bit? They look so cool in different lights and stuff like this. But when I have... Now you can... Oh, there. Can you guys see the purple? Isn't that cool? They just go from green to purple. Isn't that awesome? Oh, Mandy, we're going to work in Sagar Oksagner from Emily Oberg. But before we get started on what we're going to work on, I have an unboxing for you guys. I just got my gift today. So for those of you that don't know, our anniversary is actually Tuesday, the 19th, and Frank told me yesterday to get something that I had my eye on, so I'm going to be showing that to you in a minute or two. We're going to open it up and look at it together, so it's going to be fun, and I like saving that for the streams because I appreciate you guys coming. Thank you. Hey, Sarah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it'd be 9 years for us this year. So... Hey, Candace, there you are. Candace, are you able to be a moderator for me? And Beth, you're the one that asked me yesterday, right? If you could be, or is it Becky? I think it's Beth. Sorry, I have so many conversations. Hey, Jillian. I know, Stacy, right? Almost a decade, I can't believe it. Next year, the big 10 years, Frank wants to have a recommitment, redoing of our vows ceremony in Disney World next year. I'm just reading your comments and trying to drink my extremely hot tea. Look at I don't know if you can still see all the smoke coming out of that. So let's move that over there. All right, so I'm going to... Okay, Beth, you are the moderator as well as Mona. Oh, congratulations, Becky. Today is your anniversary with your hubby for 32 years. That's amazing. You know what? I would just be happy if I could fit back into my wedding dress, Stacy. I don't think it's going to happen. I'm not, like, grossly disgusting from what I used to be. It's nothing like that. It's just that, I was 29 when I got married, and now it's almost 10 years later, and I doubt I'm going to fit into that after a baby. So we'll see. I have a whole year to work on that, right? So... Okay, so moderators, you guys know what to do. If anything doesn't look right, boot them out. You know how it goes. So why don't we go ahead and get started on the unboxing? So I got two things, but I'm going to show you the best thing to start because, you know, why not? So I got the 120 set of the Supercolor pencils. Yeah! I am so excited about these, you guys. I have been using these. I broke these guys out. Let me open them while we're talking. I broke these guys out of the closet. I have the 80 set, and I hadn't used them in ages. I want to try to do this without scratching the tin here. So I haven't used them in ages, and I saw Katrine using them, and I said, oh, I have those. Let me see what I can do with mine. And I don't use them as watercolors. I just use them as regular pencils. And I have been using them constantly. I love them so much, and they've become my second favorite pencil after my Polys. So they do sell these open stock at My Dick Blick, which is a really nice thing. And I said to Frank, I saw them on Amazon, the 120 set, and I said, oh, I would really like to have those. And I said, could I get those for Christmas? So he said yes, and then yesterday he said to me, hey, our anniversary is Tuesday, go order those pencils. So I got them. So I'm just trying to get the sticker off here. Oh, you just ordered 5 of the open stock from Blix. Amber, yeah, they're really nice. I really like these pencils a lot. They are not as hard as the Pablos, but they are basically the same colors, but they are much softer. And they're not as soft as like the Prismacolors, but I don't know how to explain it really, but they're wonderful. Hey, Melvina. So let's open them up together and take a look at the beauties. So we have the standard Caran d'Ache little flyer pamphlet thing. Oh, look at these. I love them. He is so sweet, isn't he? Oh, hey, Audra. Sorry about that. Oh, the strawberry field and strawberry. Okay. I'm glad somebody pointed that out to me because I would have totally missed that. So let me write that in there. Okay. Hey, Tati. Thanks for joining. I know you were working tonight. Much appreciated. All right. So let's see here. This is like moving so fast. Okay. All right, so we have the first tray. And we have the second tray. Oh my gosh, I think these two trays are the ones that I have in the 80 set. And these colors are so beautiful. I love, especially this one. I work with this one a lot. As a matter of fact, the book we're gonna work in tonight, what did I do with it? I use these pencils on it. Grace says the clone machine would be busy if we could clone Frank. Yes, I know. He's a really good guy. He loves me. So I used these pencils on this picture. So the only thing I didn't use, these pencils were not used on the mushrooms, but everything else I used these pencils for. So you can see they give you really nice bright colors. And then I did also use these on this. So I really, really like these pencils. They're really nice, beautiful. They go on very smooth, soft, and I've really enjoyed working with them. So I'm so excited to have the full set of these. Oh, hold on 1 second. Let me move the dog. Belle's up here. She's last to sit in the fan because she gets too hot. Beth says she's going for another train ride. I'm telling you guys, choo-choo, these are so nice. I wouldn't lie to you. I wouldn't have bought these if I already have the 80 set, if I didn't absolutely love them. Okay. Let's go to the next tray. Guys, forgive my fingers. They are terribly, terribly swollen, and my arthritis is very bad. As you can see, I can't, they're just not working right. So we're just gonna go with it. It's a part of life. I'm not gonna worry about it. But here is, let's see, how can we do this? Here is tray three. Ooh, I love these. And like I said, I don't use them for watercolors. You can, but I don't. I don't like watercolor pencils for some reason. I mean, I do like the Inktense, but yeah. So yeah, we are extremely happy with these. So Mona's gonna go order. She'll be right back. All right, so let's see how I can set these up for tonight, because I would like to use them tonight on our picture. And he bought me this little case for them. So let's see if we can get this open. Okay. So this is the little, what do we call this? It's the BTKSY. It's like all the other ones that I have, but this is my preferred case for my pencils. I like that it's small, and you know, it's the same as all the other ones. So I will be putting these in here tonight. This is, I think, is this the 150? I don't know what this is. It might just be the 120. Whatever it is, this is the one that I got. And I will be putting these in here later tonight. Even though I like the tray very much, I still need to put them in the case. So oh, Becky wants to know. Sorry, guys. I'm just drinking because it's really hot up here. It's so humid in New York tonight. Let's put the pencils back in the screen so that we can look at the beauteousness before we start coloring. So Becky wants to know how these are different from the Luminance pencils. Now, I don't have a full Luminance pencil set. I have tried them multiple times in the stores, and I don't care for them, only because they are very hard. I have the white Luminance pencil, which I use for blending and stuff like that, but they're a harder pencil. So if you like harder pencils, then that would probably be a good option for you. These are much softer, which you'll see as we start coloring. So why don't we go ahead and do that? I will start setting this up so that we can get some coloring done. I don't have like the largest desk set up here, so just bear with me for a second. Who is my biggest enabler? Is that what somebody was asking? Frank. My husband is my biggest enabler. I do, Debbie, I do like these better than the Pablos. I use these a whole lot more than the Pablos, just because they're a softer pencil, and I find that they just, like, glide on the page. Hey, Anne. Oh, okay. Okay, Audra. You'll have to let us know how those work for you. I've never heard of them. Yes, Colleen, I did. Well, I think I figured it out. Let's see. I was working with it last night. I'm trying to find a pencil here now while we're talking. I was working with it last night. Now, I let Frank look at it too, and he was saying that, like, the idea is good behind it, but the execution, not so good. So, I'm trying to find my little pencil case, which, of course, you can never find when you're looking for something, right? Where is my Star Wars pencil case? It's lost. I have no idea what happened to it. It's in here somewhere. I'll find it as soon as the stream is over. But let me just pick a pencil that's not sharp, and I'll show you how it works. Okay, so you're supposed to use one and then two. I should empty this also, right? You're supposed to use one to sharpen it and two to sharpen the lead. But then you have these other things in here. Look at this. See these little dudes in here? You're supposed to use those, I believe, to sharpen the leads, because you have the little hole on the side that you're supposed to stick the lead in, but it doesn't work. Frank tried it many, many times. It just did not work. So what I do, I can't get it closed. Sorry, guys, my fingers just are not working. Okay, so here we go. Oh, I should show you. This is where we're at. So I sharpen it in one, and I sharpen it to where I want it to go. So about there, and then I just stick it in the second one and put it in there, and then it gets pretty sharp. So I don't know if that's the way you're supposed to use it or if you're supposed to do something different with it, but it works nice for me, and I was using it all last night, and as you can see, it gets a nice point. I didn't have any problems with it, and I used it on my Prismacolors, which was the big test because I was worried that it would break them, but it seemed fine. I didn't have any problems with it at all. So I have a loose pencil here. Okay, got it. Oh, I found my Star Wars pencil case. I knew that I would as soon as I was done. Okay, so we're going to be working in Sagar Oxsagner by Emily Oberg. We're going to do this little page with my new pencils. Yes, I do have the extra blades in there. I do, but I don't need them yet because they're still sharp. So, all right, so let me pick some colors here and see what I want to do. And we will get started. So can you guys see it? Do you need me to, I don't know if I can zoom in here. Let's see. Hey, Robin. Oh, I can zoom. Oh, cool. Okay. All right, so let's try to color some. So I'm going to try to hold the pencil this way so you can see what I'm doing. I'm using hardly any pressure on this. These really glide on, and I don't know if that's because they are watercolor pencils or they're just really soft pencils, but they're not as soft as the Prismacolors. They don't crumble or anything like that. They're just really, I love these. I love them. Like I said, they're my second favorite pencils now after my Polychromos. So you're going to see a lot of my pictures with these, and I already showed you the two that I worked on. Yes, Pink Eye Pro. Yes, I have my Star Wars case. I always keep it with me. I know you gave it to me, and I think of you every time I use it. I have my pencils in there, and I have my sharpeners in the case that Christy gave me. I have that right here, too. This is the one that Christy gave me, and I have all my little sharpeners and stuff in there. You see that? And then I have my other case. Here's my little slip. Sorry, I'm having like a brain fart. And I have all my little pencils and Posca and all that kind of stuff in there. Okay, so what are we saying here? And I'm horrified when I watch you and I see everything all over the desk. I'm like, oh my God. No, I'm just kidding. Everybody has to work how they feel most comfortable. So don't listen to me. I like to have my things organized. And I need to because I have a 2-year-old. So I have to. Plus I have 3 dogs who also like to steal things and sit on my stuff and everything else. So okay, Mona, no problem. Have fun with your friends, not a problem at all, girl. So, have you guys started coloring any autumn or fall or Halloween pictures yet? Grace, I think you're going to have to stop watching Anne and me because you are definitely enabled. I had put on the Facebook page earlier today that we broke Amazon again with that Cityscape book that I showed yesterday. They're all sold out on Amazon. But I did put a place that you can get it. Was it Colored Craft or something like that? I think it was Colored Craft that you could get it from, so. Oh, you finished the Medusa, Tati? Did you post that yet? Oh, you got the Magical Witches book? Cool, Nicole. Is that the Deborah Muller one? What am I doing here? I don't even know what I'm doing here. Like I said, guys, just don't mind my hands, because my hands are not working the best, so if it looks a little off, it's just, that's the reason why. Okay, so Becky got, oh wait, Susan's been coloring in the Nikki Burnett Cute Witches. Becky got Mally Harrison's Autumn Fantasy. Tracy is waiting for her Durant Pro Color pencils to come. That's gonna be fun. I love coloring Halloween stuff too, Christy. I've been busy working on Halloween pictures and some fall stuff, because you know we have our color along coming up pretty soon, and that's gonna take up a fair amount of time. So I want to get in some other coloring, because I have so many fall books and pictures. I'll show you guys what I was working on yesterday. I actually worked on it last night and finished it. You've been good, no buying supplies, Candace. That's good. You don't have a fall or Halloween book yet? You gotta get one, Meredith. Where is my other book? I'm telling you, I'm such a, like, disheveled mess when I come up here. Okay. Tati is window shopping on Amazon. I love it. Yes, that is good for her. Okay, so this is what I'm working on right now. I started this one today after work. And Grace is working on, she's coloring the elf in Chibi Girls, a witch in Witch Fantasy, and we'll continue on with it tomorrow. Lisa said, Candace, are you feeling okay? That's funny. All right, and let me show you what the other picture was that I did last night. I got on a roll with this last night, and I finished it. So I started this and finished it. I use my Prismacolors, some Sharpie markers, and are you not proud? I used some Sharpie markers, and I used the Pebble Pastels, and of course some Stickles. I don't know if you can, yeah, you can see the Stickles there. So I had a lot of fun working on this, and actually the Prismacolors work really well on this Hanolin paper. Even though this is CreateSpace paper, it's a little bit thicker than some of the other ones. Like the Jade Summer ones, oh my god, I almost had a heart attack the other night. I was working on a Jade Summer picture that I was doing for a buddy color, and I decided to do Crayola, all Crayola on the book. So I did Crayola Super Tips, Crayola pencils, crayons, all of it, right? But I didn't have like a flesh color for her face, so I decided to do, I took out my Prismacolor, and you know the back of the Jade Summer pages are black. Oh my god, I like flipped out. I was like, what the hell did I just do here? It, like, her face went muddy. It looked awful, but when it dried, it was okay. But I was like, oh my gosh, what did I just do here? I made like a disaster out of this. But I didn't have the same, like, experience with the Hanolin. It didn't seem to soak through the page as much as it did with the Jade Summer. So I think her paper may be a little bit thicker. Oh! Oh, Christy, you're working in Hannah Lynn too? That's cool. Which picture are you doing? I only did one picture from her book last year. I got the book last year when I first started coloring, and I only did one picture from it. So I'm determined to do a few more this year. And I also have a plan in mind. Let me get that back out. So I did this picture. This was the only picture that I did last year. And this is like I said, when I first started coloring, I did this October 20th last year. And what I'm going to do is, since there's two of each in this book, I'm going to do this one this year to see. I'm going to try to use the same colors, and I don't obviously know all the products I used. I know I used some pencil and some markers, and of course my son drew on it over here, so there's that. But my plan is to use the same colors and do this picture and see what the difference is going to be from my coloring last year to this year, so I can see you know, what I've learned and what I'm doing. Oh, I don't know, Grace. Anne is going to have to explain that to you. Because she's all up in the Cali marker business. She knows all about it. So she'll probably be able to tell you. I don't know anything about that. I just use my Sharpie markers and my, what do you call those? The Crayola Super Tips, because I'm not a marker girl. I don't have too much of it, and I don't work with them too much, though. So. But, you know, I do what I do. Oh, thank you. Thanks, Tracy. You're working on the Halloween Princess, Christy? I can't wait to see it. I know, right, Nick? My 1 year my 1 year anniversary is coming up. Nick, Natalie. I always call you Nick when I see your thing, but I know it's Natalie. Yeah, I started this. I was telling Shalene today. I started this whole crazy train ride a year ago, and you know, I feel a little accomplished with what I've learned. I know I still have a long way to go, but I feel happy with what I've done. Oh, they sent you some more yesterday, Anne? That's good. Okay, we're going to be seeing the review for that. Robin says, Anne has me stuck in Aikuko's two books. They're gorgeous. Plus, Anne put Jade Summer's fantasy book in my cart. Oh, okay. Easy Essie said she just ordered the Cityscape from Colored Craft. Oh, okay, you got the one with the Bavarian German festival. I love that book. It's definitely, I mean, I never expected it to be, but it's definitely rose up to one of my favorites. I'm gonna actually turn the book. You're coloring sunflowers right now, Jillian. You're in denial that summer's over. Yeah, I am so done with summer. I am so done with it. Ready for the nice, cool weather, to be in my sweats and fuzzy socks, and I love that. That's really nice, Anne. That shows that they really care about their they really care about their customers, and that they want to show their product off with somebody that knows how to use them. So that's a really good thing. Candace said the no buying is killing her. I can imagine. Oh my gosh, guys, this tea is so good. This is the Teavana Samurai Chai Mate. I love this stuff. You can do it, Melvina. We told you in Dee Dee's chat that you just need to do it. You just need to jump in and start doing it. You're not gonna know what it's about or if you like it unless you just do it. So So for anybody that's just coming in, I'm using the, what the heck am I using? I'm using these Caran d'Ache Super Color pencils. Frank just got them for me. He got me the 120 set for our anniversary, which is Tuesday. He told me yesterday to order them and they came today, and he very generously let me have them early so that I could use them for tonight. And he got me a lovely case to go with them. And as I was telling everybody, these are my favorite, they're my second favorite pencils now. They are water soluble pencils. So they are, see how they have the little, oh, I don't know if you can see it. Oh, oops, sorry, shook the camera. Sorry. Do you see the little water brush on there? This is probably like the worst pencil to pick. Do you see the little gold water brush? That means that you can use water on them. But I don't use them as watercolors because I have a plethora of other watercolor products. I really like these as pencils. They blend nicely, they're nice and soft. I really like them. Oh, I love pumpkin spice. I wish I had me a pumpkin spice latte from Starbucks right now. You just did your first Bennett Klein, Nancy? What did you use on it? Lisa, I'm not in that stage yet, but I can agree. You just don't need flannels. When you get to a certain age, it's like, no, I need to be in like shorts all the time. I love my sweatshirts and like when it gets really, really cold here and stuff like that. But yeah, there's a lot of times I just wear the fan. Yeah, I wear the fan in the wintertime. I keep the fan on in the wintertime. Hey, Angie. No, I don't speak Spanish, Dala Diva. Sorry, Nisi. I understand it a little bit. I actually got a score of 80 on my Spanish Regents. And I understand a little bit of German, and I can say a few things in German because when I was growing up, my best friend, her grandparents spoke German. So I can understand Spanish when it's spoken to me for the most part, but I can't really speak it anymore. Why do you ask? No, I'm not a young lady anymore, Lisa. Hey, Rosalyn. Oh, Nancy used your Prismas. Did you color in the book, or did you have printed out on like cardstock paper? I'm sure you guys can hear my friends, the crickets outside there. They are just chirping up a storm again tonight. They've been in all my videos lately. Yeah, I'm hot natured too. Definitely. My mom is always freezing. And, like, she comes here, it's 80 degrees, and she has a sweat coat on. I'm like, what are you doing, woman? But she's always cold. Not me. Not Frank either, so we're lucky that we both are the same kind of, like, temperature. And my son is, like, pissed off because I've been telling him he has to start wearing pants. Some nights it's a little chilly and I want to put, like, pants on him for his PJs. He is not having it. He's like, nope, I'm a shorts guy, Mom. And he's, like, flips out and takes his pants off. So, yeah. Oh, how's he doing with the mosquitoes? They love him, so as soon as he goes outside, they're all over him. So I do have to put the bug spray on him when we go sit outside. But, you know, what can you do? It's the season for the mosquitoes, so I just try to keep him as covered, you know, as protected as possible. I tried putting the lavender on him, and he woke up with, like, mosquito bites all over him, so that they liked it. I think they just like his scent a lot, so he naturally attracts them.
Ha, 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 ha.
I entering the old hag season? Is that what you're saying? I'm not arguing, just asking. Oh, are they really loud, Becky? Yeah, they don't sound that loud to me, like, here now, but when I watch back the video, I do hear they are kind of loud. Are they annoying? Should I shut the window? Nisi, you think I have a beautiful Latina New York accent? That's the first time I've heard that. Definitely, not of Latin descent in any way. I am Irish and German. But thank you. Like I said, it's the first time anyone ever told me that. Just sharpening my pencil again. I am so excited for the fall season, you guys. I really like it. I already put some of my decorations up, and I think probably maybe the first weekend of October we're gonna go do like our pumpkin picking thing, because now that we have Emilio, we kind of like to do more than one event. So they have this thing near us called I can't even think of what it's called now, but basically what it is, it's a walkthrough thing that you do at nighttime, and it's all carved pumpkins, and they are like crazy carved pumpkins. With like one year they had the Walking Dead carved pumpkins, and they have like the music playing, and you walk through it. It's really, really cool. If you want to look it up, it's at the Westbury Gardens. So take a look at that. You can see what it's called. I can't think of what it's called at the moment, but it's like an event. The only thing is, it's $50 to go to it, which is not that bad because you can be there for a few hours or so. But the thing is, it sells out way, way in advance. And I'm not okay with it because it's $50 a person. And if it rains, you lose your money because it's all outside. So, yeah, I mean, like, I don't want to really lose $100 on this pumpkin thing. Especially with my health, if it's something like that I can't go to or whatever, you know. So I kind of, when it first started, you could be, like, you could get tickets that day, but now they really sell out in advance. So that's the only thing I'm kind of hesitant on, but I would really like to take Emilio to go see that because it's really awesome. And then, of course, we do the pumpkin picking, we go to the farms. And the farm we go to, they have like a hay ride. They don't have like a cornfield, but they have a hay ride that Amelia really likes. They have pony rides, and they have a play area for the kids, and it's so much fun. And then our dads, Frank's dad and my dad, are actually buried in the same cemetery, not very far from each other. And so it's right by the place where we go to go pick pumpkins. So we go, since we've been dating, so for like 12 years, we've been going to do this together and then going to visit our dads together. And after that, now Emilio's here with us. So we've included him in on it, and he can go see his two grandpas. So it's kind of fun. We bring them little pumpkins for their area at the cemetery. Yes, I will show you my nails, Candace. Okay, so now you guys look. You see how it's got the switch? It's got the purple. And if I move back, it's got the green. Isn't that so cool? I love these mermaid nails. They are awesome. I love how in different lights they're different colors. This is just a gel nail polish. So I don't know if it has a name. As far as I know, it just had a number. But I'm going to get my nails done Saturday, so I'll have to see what I get then. Hey, Zuma. Oh, you do a lot of apple picking, Melvina? We haven't done that. I need to do that. Hey, Katrina. Thanks, Roslyn. It's not a chrome nail polish. It's very glittery, but I don't know. I like it. So, I don't know what I'm going to get Saturday, but we shall see. So, those are our plans for the fall season. We've been doing some stuff on the weekends. Like, we went to Hobby Lobby this past weekend, which was fun because they just opened one of those up locally for us. So, we went there. And what else did we do? We've done things a little. Oh, we went to see this thing at, it's like a artillery, like a heavy artillery place. Natalia, this is Sagar Ox Sagner. So we went to go see like tanker trucks and stuff like that, which Emilio loved. So that was a lot of fun. And then we did something else, and now I can't think of what it was. Oh, we took him to a zoo. And I took some pictures of the peacocks to show Anne. but we took him to like a little petting zoo, and it was a lot of fun. So we've had some busy weekends these past few weekends, so I'm not going to be doing anything crazy this Saturday. This Saturday is a coloring day for me. I'm going to be spending the day coloring and relaxing because I've had, you know, like I said, we've done a lot of stuff, and I'm very tired. I've had some insomnia last night and go to bed till 4 o'clock in the morning. I just couldn't fall asleep. I had some problems sleeping because of the storm. I was worried about, a lot of people. My mother-in-law is in Florida. So I just want a relaxing Saturday, and that's what we're going to do. Oh, you can't have painted nails, Angie? When I worked at the Disney store, we weren't allowed to have anything like crazy either. I don't know if those rules have changed since I worked there, because it was like, 500 years ago. But we weren't allowed to have them past a certain length and any certain colors. They had to be very plain. Natalie, I'm using the Caran d'Ache Super Colors. These are the watercolor pencils that they have, but you can use them wet or dry. I have the same problem, Tati. Unless I have my acrylics on, or I have, something like that on. Like, these are just, it's acrylic over my own nails. But unless I have that on, the nail polish is useless. It comes off in a day. Okay, Tati, let me know what they're doing for their nails over at the Disney store these days, because I'm not sure. I know it's like changed hands a few times, so I think they're owned again by Disney. I know for a while they weren't. When I worked there, they were. So, not sure. All right, so I've worked on these, and I'm going to have to work on these some more, but what I want to do is I want to work on the leaves a little bit, so that we can see some other colors just besides the brown. Let's see here. Oh, I know. Hobby Lobby is so fun, isn't it? I love that store. I can't believe how nice it is. I'm just picking colors while we're talking here. What do I want to do here? Let's just do some greens so we can see what they look like. Okay. They have such nice stuff at Hobby Lobby. I was so surprised at all the stuff that they had, because I had never been to one before, but like I said, they opened one up by us, so. All right, this thing is full, and I think it's going to break my pencil, so I better not sharpen it anymore. I'll move on to this one. Natalie, I have the Luminance pencil. Like, I have a white one. That's the only one that I have. And it's okay, but it's a very hard pencil. Can you guys see what I'm doing here? Let me zoom in a little bit more. It's a very hard pencil, and hard pencils hurt my hands, and I'm just not crazy about the Luminance pencils. I've tried to like them a few times when I go, like, they have them open stock at Dick Blick. So I've tried to like them, but to be honest, they're just, like, not my thing. I do like the white pencil for blending, though. These ones I just really, really like. There's just something about them. They're soft, but not too soft, and I like the way they blend. And I'm just, like, really thrilled that I have the full set of these now. And when I get done here, I'm going to put them in my case and probably finish working on this picture, because you know me, I'll never finish this in whatever time I spend here. But I would love to know what your favorite pencils are out there, what you guys all work with, and what your favorites are. Because we all have our favorites, and there's nothing wrong with that. All right, let's see. I don't know how this color is going to go, but let's see. Can you guys see what? Oh, yeah, you can see. I like these pencils a lot because they're very, very vibrant. See how bright the colors are? I just really like them, and they blend really nicely. And of course, if you like watercolor pencils, they're perfect for that too. So you can really do a lot with these. And I find that they don't wear down as fast as my other pencils. Like, I didn't bring up the 80 set that I have, but I do find that they don't wear down as fast as like the Prismacolors or the Polys. Okay, so Becky says the Polys are her favorite. Angie still likes her Pro Colors, but her all-time favorite are her Pablos. Frances likes her Prisma and her Luminance. Stacy says her only good ones are her Prisma. Crystal says Prisma for her. Anne says Prismas, Ergosoft, Fila, and Lelix. Anne, you're only supposed to pick one. No, I'm just kidding. Strawberry Board, I'm sorry, that's Amber. She said she likes her Prismacolors and her Polys the most, but she loves her Marco Refines or Raffines. Tati says she hasn't gone beyond the Prismacolors. Oh, and you have the Chloe Noirs. I have those too. I like those too. Those are nice. Candace's house is a Dick Blick. But she likes her Prismas. Okay, Michelle likes Derwent. Katrina likes Prismas and Polys and Spectrum Noir. Beth has the Chloe Noirs, but she doesn't like them. I have not tried the Hero oil-based pencils, but I think some people in our group have. Nancy says Prismas. Beth says Polys for sure. Melvina still really loves her Prismas. Susan says she thinks the Filas are a great cross between Polys and Prismas. They're really nice. Meredith says she just pulled out her 18 pack of Caran d'Ache and using it now to color, now as color pencils for her page. Oh, I opened the door for you. That's awesome. Katrina likes Prisma, Spectrum Noir, and Polychromos. Lisa likes Polys and Prismas also. Now, Lisa, your Albrecht Dürer pencils, do you use those as regular pencils, or are you using those as, like how I'm doing it here is pencils to color with? Because those are rather rough, aren't they? Like, those are like really true watercolor pencils. These are not like that at all. These are not rough, because I know some watercolor pencils can be rough depending on obviously what book you're working on. Rosalind says Derwent Artist. She didn't like them at first, but now she loves them. Lori's learning her Prismas, but she likes her Polys. Tara says she likes her Crayola and Fantasia pencils. Nancy says Koei Tritones also. Strawberry Fields, that's Audra. She likes her Polys and Blicks. Wow, you guys see, I think that's awesome, because as you can see, everybody likes something different. And that is like one of the great things about the coloring community. Hey, Nicole. Is that there's so many people that like so many different things for so many different reasons. So I think when you see people that someone's gonna have to take care of the drooling colorist over here. Thank you, Tati. I'm telling you. It does move fast, Anne, but now I totally forgot what I was gonna say. Oh, yes, so it's really nice in the coloring community that so many people like so many different things. And everybody has their own reasons. Like, just for example, and I'm only gonna single her out because, you know, she's here and she films, but like, Anne really is crafty with her markers. She knows how to use them, she knows how to blend them. And that probably is one of her favorite mediums. And that's just something that she started with and fell in love with. And then there's other people like myself that really love my pencils. And that's what I really fell in love with. No particular reason, it's just what I fell in love with. So everybody has their own stuff. And I think that that is very cool that a lot of people also are willing to try other stuff. I think sometimes in life we're hesitant to change or try new things, but with coloring you find so many things that give you a lot of pleasure as far as the tools that you use that we just want more and more and more to try it, and hopefully it'll give us that same feeling. So I love that. I love that in the coloring community that everybody has different, I guess, different likes and different uses for stuff, and nobody fights over it. You ever notice that, like, in the community, no one's like, well, this is better, mine is better, my ideas are better. Nobody does that here. Everyone just like, oh, you like that? I'm gonna try it. And it's nice. That is a nice thing about the community. That's exactly it. We learn from each other and we try new things, and I think that's very cool, because I'd be less inclined to work with my markers if I didn't watch Anne's videos, because there's not that many people that work with the markers on a regular basis anyway. Most people do pencil work. And not only the people that film, but other people that are on the page, we all inspire each other and give each other, you know, not only inspiration, but you just give each other the positivity that it's okay to try something and see how it goes. And there's so many different things that you can learn and try here. You're constantly learning, and it's a nice, it's a nice feeling to constantly be learning something, especially when you're not a kid and you're not in school and you're not trying to learn something. It's a new craft that you can always improve upon. You can always learn a new technique. So, oh, you're learning how to do the leaves for me, Stacy? Okay. Oh, hey, Crystal. You changed your name. Yes, encouragement, Tati. Thank you. That was the word I was looking for. Corey, yes, I got new pencils. That's right, Nancy. Nobody does do that in this community, at least not in our group. And I'll say it's a group because we all converse with each other on the Facebook pages and stuff like that. Nobody does do that. Nobody badmouths you. No one looks down upon you. Everyone's really encouraging for whatever you want to use, for whatever your reasons are. And nobody says, oh, you don't have that book, well, then you can't be included. It's not like that at all in our group. And I love that dynamic of our group. Okay, good night, Robin. Thanks for joining us. Okay, now I'm gonna try to move the book around. Maybe I should zoom out a little bit. Hold on a second, guys. Let me zoom out a little bit. Okay, there we go. So every time I do my leaves, I do them different. I don't have, like, a consistent way of doing things. I always try different stuff to see how it goes, so. This is just the way I'm doing it for tonight because it's the easiest, and I don't have to concentrate on it too hard. But there we go. I agree, Audra. I haven't seen anything but kindness in this group too, and if we do, we'll make sure to take care of it. Oh, thanks, Anne. Yeah, well, I have you to thank because, you know, I came to your stream and I saw that it really didn't look hard. It looked pretty easy, and I was having really a lot of, like, issues with the Ustream thing, with the lag. That was my only problem with it, because, honestly, as far as the tech stuff goes, this is exactly the same as it was for the Ustream thing. But the lag on it was, like, unbelievably bad. And with Instagram, I just didn't like that when I would upload it, you couldn't see the whole thing. It was really bothersome. So this seems to be just the easiest thing. You guys seem to be able to join it much easier and chat easier. So if you're happy, I'm happy. Grace is going to Blick. What are you going to the Blick store for? Oh, thanks, Candace. Which picture? The little witch that I did yesterday? I'm trying to do all kinds of, like, fall pictures and stuff right now. You know, guys, I haven't read a book, and I can't even remember the last time. I hate to say it, but it's true. Zuma, I'm coloring in the Sagor Ak Sagnar right now. The Blick pencils are nice. I have those. They're a lot nicer than I thought they would be, actually. They're very creamy, and they have nice color. I don't use them that much, but they're very nice pencils. I'd say they're comparable to Prismacolors. Hey, Cuddle Girl, what's your name? We're working in Sagor Ak Sagnar. Who needs an intervention? Those are for quitters. We have no quitters in this group. You're still reading Evelyn Hugo, Tati? Oh my gosh, what are you doing? How far are you into it? You should be speeding through that. That book is so good. Yes, you did, Corey. You were the one that suggested to me to get the Blick ones, and I did get them, and they are nice. Actually, I had mentioned it to Frank, and one day he just snuck it in the cart when we were checking out, so I told you, he's my biggest enabler. My favorite coloring book or my favorite reading book? Gosh, my fingers are so swollen. My arthritis is, like, off the chain. Okay, Amber, thanks for joining us. Yeah, I think the Blick pencils would be a great choice for work. It's something that you can leave there. I think this is only a 72 set, so it's not that big. You can get a nice small case for it, and that would be a great thing. You could just stick in your drawer and leave it there. I also color during my working hours, like when I have a conference call. If it's not something I have to participate in but just have to listen, I told my boss, and I told her, I was like, I listen a whole lot more on the call when I'm coloring than ever before. So I do that. Or sometimes on my lunch break, if it's a particularly like stressful day, I'll just pull out my stuff. I mean, obviously I work from home, so I can pull out anything that I want to, but I'll just take out my stuff and just take a half an hour for my lunch and just color. And you wouldn't believe like how much stress release it is. You can't get off the enabling train because you might miss something good if you get off the enabling train. Hey, Kathy. I'm telling you, Anne, these pencils are nice. They blend beautifully. I'm hardly putting any pressure on these at all. They're very bright. Anne, did you see the pictures that I showed that I worked on with these in this book? I'll show them again for anybody that's new that's coming in. But I've worked on this before, on this book with these, because I have the 80 set of these pencils. Not that picture. That one I did my Pablos with. So I worked on this one with the Pablos. But I did this one with these pencils. And of course, there's some nice stickles on there. And I did this one with these pencils. The only thing I didn't do with these pencils was the mushrooms. Everything else was done with these super color pencils. Crystal's telling you, Grace, no, you can't get them. You know, Christmas is coming, guys, so put them on your list. And what I would say, too, is watch on Amazon, because the price on these things go up and down. Like the Derwent Artist Pencils, the price has gone down to like $40 on those things recently. So things change on a regular basis on Amazon. These at one time were up to $250 on Amazon. Oh, no. I'm not going to say it on the stream, but... Grace says, everybody enables me. I take a pen and paper when watching YouTube channels and see what I can get and afford. I know, it. You do. It's just natural. I think everybody gets enabled by somebody at some time or another. But that's a beautiful thing, because there's so many lovely things you can try. Like, I saw on Anne's channel, I don't know how I missed it, but I saw the flip through of the Grayscale Christmas book that she just did. Anyone else see that? That looks freaking beautiful. Like, I can't wait to get that book. That's definitely gonna have to be like a color book for the Christmas season, because that is so pretty. And I may never have known about it if someone didn't show it on their channel. So, in this case, it was Anne. So, I mean, you know, it's nice that everybody can show different stuff. Hi, DeMonte. Oh, you just got your Russian Mermaids coloring book, Melvin. Enjoy it. It doesn't take her very long to ship it, so... You should have it soon. I think it took about 12 days from when I ordered it. Now, again, I always say this on my streams, guys, but I'm not as close to the page as I normally am when I color. So if it doesn't look 100% like my usual coloring, it's because I'm not as close. I have the camera and the light, like, in the way, so I can't see it or be as close to it. And also, my hands are just giving me issues tonight, so just bear with me, but I'm doing the best that I can. Oh, Nancy says she ordered all of Ruth's books because of that video. Yeah, what pretty pictures. That is going to be such a beautiful book to color. What book are you talking about, Fiona? Oh, thank you guys. I appreciate it. Oh, Susan, you've been coloring in the Goldilocks one already? Yeah, that one's super cute too. I still haven't gotten my book from Clara Markova, guys, and yeah. I think we're going to be having some issues with it because it hasn't moved since like the 4th, and I'm not the only one. There's several of us that there's no movement on the book. So, very disappointed. Oh, yeah, Linda Ravenscroft's books are really nice, Melvina. I have one of those too. Fiona, there's a lot of books I don't have yet. I'm not sure. Who's the artist that you're talking about? Are you talking about the Clara Markova book? The Tearful Endearments or whatever it is? I have not gotten that. I ordered it. I ordered it the day it was released, but I have not gotten it yet. And other people in my state have gotten their books, so whatever they were trying to tell me the other day is just not the truth. It is, Candace. It's extremely irritating, especially because I did not get a nice response from them when I asked if they could just check on it for me to make sure everything was the way it's supposed to be. So that was what was most disappointing about it. I don't mind waiting as long as it's doing what it's supposed to do and it does not appear like it's even moving. So that's extremely irritating. Grace is up to 284 coloring books, everyone. Fiona, how long ago did you order your book? This is the first time I've ever had a problem with anyone on Etsy, and the shipping and stuff, and it's like extremely disappointing. Yeah, I would wait too, Beth, because for anyone that doesn't know, I wrote about it on the Facebook page. I contacted them. I did not hear back from Clara on Etsy. I heard back from someone that's supposed to be like a manager or something like that. And they were not friendly about it. They basically just told me to wait and that they weren't going to check on it for me. But as of the 16th, you can contact them again because I guess that's the time frame. And I intend on it. I'm going to contact them again. Did you contact them, Candace? Yeah, Daisy, but when it's supposed to have shipped out already and it's not moving, and I'm not the only one, I believe there's a problem with it. Yeah, Anne already got her book and we ordered on the same day. There is no reason that mine wouldn't even have movement. Mona showed me yesterday. She has movement. Hers is practically to her in Miami, and they just went through a hurricane. So, whatever excuse they're giving me, I don't buy it, and I'm just not very pleased with how I was responded to. And I'm very disappointed because we all paid a lot of money for that book, and I didn't ask them to present the book to me. I asked them to check on it to make sure everything was okay, and I didn't get a nice response. You should be able to file a claim on the 16th, Tati, but make sure you contact them first before you file a claim. Yeah, we have till the 16th, Daisy. If you ordered it the day that it was released, contact them. That's the only way that we're going to get anything happening here is to contact them and let them know that, you know, there's no movement on the book. It's still stuck in Czechoslovakia or wherever she's sending it from. I agree, Rosalind. The thing is, you know, I didn't ask for a lot. I just wanted them to check on it. And I was basically just told no. They weren't going to check on it, which I didn't appreciate because we've all, anybody that ordered that book spent a lot of money to order it. I think when the book came out on the 30th, didn't it? Okay, bye, Francis. Yeah, the Zemla Genova Dutch version is coming out. I think you can pre-order it on the Book Depository, can't you, Grace? It should be coming out next month. Yeah, they told me that it's the tracking, it's the post office in my country. It has nothing to do with them, and that you're not able to track it from this country, from their country. Well, that's a load of baloney, because Mona was able to track it, and I know someone else on the Facebook page said they were able to track it. So Mona showed me the picture of it, said she was able to track it. Okay, bye, Anne. I'm only gonna be on for about 10 more. Nicole, did you just say you ordered 7 coloring books? You go, girl. I have enabled another reader. I feel very satisfied. You just made my night, Nicole. Oh, I'm so happy to hear that. I was just gonna say before I got tracked off of that with Nicole's awesome purchases that I'll be on for another 10 minutes and then I'm gonna sign out for the night. But I will be uploading this to YouTube, so if anybody missed the beginning, you can watch it. Like I said, I don't mind waiting, and I really hate complaining about the whole book thing. Like, I really don't want to complain about it, but there's something wrong where a whole bunch of books are not moving and other people are receiving them that live in the same area. There's just something not right, and they should check on it if you have a concern. No, Laura, the book is coming to my home. I've enabled you a lab cuddle, girl. You're welcome. Yeah, Nicole, you should join our Facebook group. It's, you can find it in the description of all my videos, but just somebody could put it in there in the chat. It's Reading with Pugs space coloring. And there's, well, I think there's 1,200 of us now. And we all enable each other and show our pictures. And we have color alongs, and basically everyone just kind of talks about their life and stuff on the page, and it's a really, really great group of people that we've all kind of just connected, and as you can see, we all kind of know each other and know what's going on. It's really nice. Okay, good night, Barbara. Thanks for joining us. Yeah, I think I'll get the Johanna Basford book. It looks nice to me. I have all her other books, so I probably will get that one. I did get a confirmation that my Fabiana Attanasio books have shipped out, the new Cinderella and Hansel and Gretel, so I'm excited for those. They should be coming shortly. And And I would just say anybody that, like, is not sure if they want those or they're just thinking about it, guys, order them, because you saw what happened with Beauty and the Beast. It just sold out, and they've never gotten it back again. Good night, Candace. Good night, Essie. Melvin, are you talking about the book that I've been talking about, the new Clara Markova book, the, oh gosh, is it Tenderful Endearments or something like that? That's the one that I'm waiting on, and there's no movement on it at all. It's just, like, stuck wherever it is. Because it just says, when I even check, like, the U.S. Postal Service, it says that it's just waiting for a shipment. And Mona was able to check hers, and it said, like, it showed it was tracked all the way to Miami, so. What are you doing, Tati? What are you getting yourself into now? Oh, did you get it, Michelle? Did you get the Italian version of it? Has it come yet? I know some people have been waiting a really long time for it, and then it got canceled on them. So, Nicole, I have to ask you, have you started coloring yet? And if so, what are you coloring in? I'm so excited that you started coloring. Oh, you have some books that are stuck overseas too? Yes, Beth, that's the book I'm waiting for. Kim Beth, I should say. Sweet. Sorry, guys, I'm just talking to Frank. He just came home. Awesome. He brought food back from the market. He's showing me all the food. Oh my god, those all look good. Cool. You should make those. Oh, Grace, yeah, I saw your flip through of that. What's his name? Mardell Rubio? I haven't seen the Halloween one. Is that one out yet? Oh, he ate his dinner already, Meredith. He just went to the market. He took the boy out for a little bit so I could have some peace and quiet. And he brought back a whole bunch of pierogies and pretzel, like cheese pretzels, you know, all really good healthy stuff. Oh, and Italian ices. We like to eat in this family, so. That's very important to marry somebody that likes to eat if you like to eat. Because if you marry somebody that doesn't like to eat, it's going to be like a constant struggle. Like, oh God, I want to eat again and that person doesn't want to. So, find yourself a foodie. Oh, you guys can hear Emilio? Yep, he's back. Get yourself some rest, Candace. If you're tired, just get yourself some rest. Don't worry about coloring. You don't have to color every night. Taco Bell. That sounds so good. Yeah, he just got all these, like, crazy pierogies, like spinach and feta, and I don't remember the other ones, but he bought, like, 3 boxes of them. They look really good. I think he got, like, a 5-cheese pizza one or something like that. We have them, not every week, but usually, like, maybe every 2 weeks or something, we'll make them with, like, chicken cutlets or something like that. Yogurt and then ice cream. That sounds good too. Oh, Taco Bell. So, Beth, was that the first meal that you had after the hurricane was Taco Bell? Because I would have so been online for that. hardly eat any fast food anymore, I have to be honest. We really don't. The only thing that we are both suckers for is Chick-fil-A. If we ever get near a Chick-fil-A, we're having that. There's, like, not even a question to either one of us. We're having Chick-fil-A. We love it. Oh, Kim Ann from A Colorful Life did that. All right, guys, it is just about 9 o'clock, so I am going to call it a night. The time goes so fast, but I want to thank you guys so much for being here for my unboxing and for coloring with me and chatting. It was a lovely night, and I thank you as always, and I will see you guys on the Facebook page, and I have some more videos going up. Candace, that video that you wanted to see with the autumn books is going to be going up probably tomorrow because it's already filmed. So thanks so much, everyone. Have a great night, and I will talk to you guys very soon.